it's just you and I. I can't stand looking at myself when I haven't. Ugh.
Yes, for now it's just me and you. Do you have any questions before we get started on anything?
Oh, that's loaded. You know, you shouldn't ask me that. Yeah, I mean, I got a lot from yesterday. And I wrote as fast as I could, but a lot of these things are in the application. And what I mean by that is, like I learn the stuff and then I have the notes and then I go into Facebook or whatever I'm trying to do and I try to do it and it doesn't work. And then I get frustrated because I kind of go down a rabbit hole and I spend an hour trying to figure out the application of what it was that I took the notes on or that I learned, right?
Learned, yeah.
And then and there's been a lot of times that I've gone to my kids or I've gone to like Tamara Hansen, who does really well with Facebook and that kind of stuff. And I'm like, it's not working. She's like, well, you're doing it wrong. And I'm like, okay, so show me then, how am I supposed to be doing this? And then she'll go in and she'll say, well, yours isn't acting like mine does. I don't know. Yours is not working. And I'm like, I know that. Right. And that seems to happen to me more often than not. And so it's like I've got all the notes, but the application of it still isn't working. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah, absolutely.
And so that's what gets so frustrating for me. And then I just go another 6 months without knowing how to do social media or, whatever. So, but I will say this, I think the most important thing for me right now, I mean, I'm not suggesting you pattern any classes. You asked, so I'm just telling
Yeah,
you.
no, absolutely.
Is figuring out either the one suite database or whatever database would be the most user friendly and building it. I don't know. I don't know. I need to figure out. Honestly, it sounds so awful, but I had a real estate agent of mine who was trying to, well, I'll be honest, he was trying to recruit me recently. He and I were on a listing to on a transaction together in January, and I was telling him, he's like, Jen, I'd really love to have you come over to my team. This has been one of the best experiences. We just did really well together, and we worked really well together as a team. And I said, I appreciate it, but I said, I need Zillow. Seven out of the eight houses I've sold in the past year have been Zillow leads. And so I said, I'm in a position right now that if I don't at least have that lead generation system, I'm not selling anything. And I said, but can I ask you something? Because he's very successful. He's been doing it forever since the earth cooled. I said, what's that number one thing? What did you do, Mike, that made it happen for you? And he said, Jen, I was an agent for a lot of years and I was doing okay. I was getting by. And he said, but when I finally said, you know what, I should probably dive into my database and just kind of really fine-tune my database, he said, when I did that, he said, my business took off and I never looked back. And I was like, what's a database?
Right.
Like, okay, what specifically are you talking about? Because I
Yeah.
want to learn that, So
So,
I think that's important.
I think that is important, for sure. And I think that is like when you think about like what is your one thing that you should focus on, that's absolutely it. As far as good morning, Leticia. Good morning. As far as
Good morning.
learning one suite, don't do it yet. Hold
Don't do it
off.
yet.
No, because especially since you're on the Zillow team, they are rolling out a new CRM in the next week or two, very shortly, that we will be learning together. The Zillow team will have a little bit more functionality with it because it's part of the Zillow package, but the office as a whole will probably all kind of transition over to that because I think it's going to be more user friendly than OneSuite. OneSuite's great. It's a system. It's free. It's fabulous. I always preach like use the free stuff. However, OneSuite doesn't have its ease of use just isn't quite there. It's kind of got a funky layout. It's a little bit cumbersome and difficult. It's a little clunky. Let's call it clunky. It's a little clunky. And I think this new one will be a better option as a version that's being provided to you that you don't have to pay for. So don't spend too much time. What I would spend the next a little bit of time doing is making sure that you have all of your contacts in like a spreadsheet format. Because what we'll be able to do, whether it's OneSuite or this new one, is we'll be able to upload those into the system instead of having to hand enter them. So if you had them on a spreadsheet with, you know, names, phone numbers, emails, you know, if they addresses, whatever information you have, just throw that all into a spreadsheet, and then we'll be able to upload those into the CRM and get you squared away with all those touch campaigns and such.
I did already put them all into a CRM, probably about a year ago.
Okay.
And I contacted all of them, people I hadn't talked to in a long time, just let them know that I was in real estate, you know, and that I would love to connect with them and that kind of thing.
Yeah.
But then honestly, for the life of me, couldn't figure out how to get them all on that drip email once a month or once every 3 months. And so it got to the point of trying to personally write out an email to each individual. One of them got to be too much and I just gave up, and because I didn't know the system. So I didn't know how to work it. So I've got all the names and everything else in it. I just don't
know what to do next. Do
with it, right. Or how to do it, you know? So
Perfect. And we'll touch on that today as well. When we cover the Creating Clients for Life, we'll kind of touch on what that follow-up campaign should look like.
Is Boomtown the one that, because I know Ed and Kara were talking about Boomtown at our Zillow meeting a while ago.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. I know they said that they had actually purchased the, I don't know what you call it, operating system or whatever it is. They purchased it so that it would be free for everybody in the office. But I was like, what the heck is a Boomtown? You know, I was like, I have no idea. And I don't like being that guy that raises their hand and goes,
like, what's
a Boomtown? You know, I just feel like an idiot. So.
Well, now, you know, you have my number. You can just text me and be like, Amy, in the meeting, they're talking about Boomtown. What's a Boomtown?
What the heck is a Boomtown?
Actually,
please explain it before I look like an idiot in front of everybody.
I was the same, Dan. I didn't know what they were talking about. I better wait and see what happens because I didn't know what was going on. It seemed like everybody got excited because they were like, oh yeah. And I was like,
I know. Everybody was just like, oh, that's awesome. Yay. Yes. You know,
I was like, okay, I'll just wait and see what is it about.
Well, that's hilarious.
I'm glad I was not the only one.
So both you guys have my phone number. So text me. If you have a question that you're embarrassed to ask in the group setting next time, just text me the question and be like, hey, Amy, they're talking about this. What's that mean? Or they're doing, like, I don't understand. And anytime that you go to like implement something that we're training on, if you're having problems getting to that, your system's not working like you think it should, or you can't even remember what you were supposed to be doing with the notes that you wrote down, like holler at me. I'm happy to hop on a call. And chances are, like, if you're having problems, somebody else probably is. And so we may, depending on what the question is, we may open it up and say, hey, we're doing an impromptu thing at 10 o'clock this morning to go over to cover Facebook again, like a little bit more in detail, a little slower. Like, we're just going to go through it step by step and I can, you know, hop on and help people that have problems. Like, I'm totally happy to do that. I want you guys to be successful. Like, my goal is for you guys to be successful. So let me help you where you need help.
I appreciate
that. Thank you. Awesome.
You don't know.
Amy, quick question. I got a phone call yesterday from some tech company. I didn't know. It said that you refer them to me, or I was. So is that something? I didn't know if I should answer it or if it was a scam or what it was.
No. So I own a company. Well, I own a franchise of a company called Cyberbacker.
Which
Abby, who's on our calls all the time, she's the one that moderates all of our video conferencing, all of our Zoom. She is my cyber backer. So it's a virtual assistant company. So we offer virtual admin type assistance to small business owners and real estate agents. So it's not a scam, but we can come in if you're thinking about growing your team or needing to add on an admin. It's an affordable way to be able to do that, to get some extra help on the tech side of things or on the real estate side of things, as far as like, you know, they can do a whole bunch of tasks, but it was a legit message. Yes.
Okay. Thank you.
Absolutely. All right.
I just wanted to make sure because, you know.
Oh, you just went all kind of choppy. I don't know if I'm My side or yours?
So I'll sign in. I have to sign in for that, right?
Say that again. It was kind of cutting out.
That it was legit.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Sorry. I said that I just wanted to make sure that it was legit. So thank you.
You're welcome. Good morning, Shauna. All right, we are going to hop.
Good morning.
Good morning. We are going to hop in with our regularly scheduled programming for the day. As always, if you have questions, feel free to interrupt me, unmute yourself, ask them. I have the chat box open, so I try to monitor that as well. Although it's hard to speak and read at the same time, so sometimes I miss things. But you can just unmute yourself. You can do the little raise hand thing on your screen if you want to, or you can just be like, hey, Amy, wait, I got a question. Totally okay. I never counted as rude. Part of the joy of Zoom. So today we're diving into creating clients for life, right? Who doesn't want clients for life? Everybody raise your hand if you want clients for life. If you don't have a picture up, you can do a little like raise hand thing, or maybe not, because then I'll have to clear it. But we'll just assume everybody wants clients for life. We know that's what Jennifer was just talking about with her CRM, right? That's what we talked about a couple weeks ago. We talked about like your database is your gold mine, because your business is in your database, right? These people that we've done business with, people that we know, like they already know us, love us, and trust us. And so we just need to figure out how to turn those into more transactions. If it's not a one and done business, right? Our goal is clients for life, so we can get repeat business, right? People that we've sold houses to or helped them sell their houses, we can help them repeat. We can get referral business. We can help out of area friends and family, right? And we can help those friends and family. We want to create clients for life, even with friends and family that never move, right? My parents have been in their home since I was 7. So a long time, over 30 years, like 35 years-ish, right? They've been in the same house for 35 years. I know that's not the norm. But in Vacaville, like some houses, like some people have been in their houses forever. I've met several clients over on the north side of Vacaville that were like the original owners of those properties that were built in the 70s, right? So it happens. And even those people that are like, oh, I'm never going to buy or sell. I'm never going to sell my house. Perfect. I still want to earn your business. I want to earn your referral business, right? So we want to create clients for life. So our repeat business, right? We have an opportunity to capture future sales, future purchases, and investment properties. So keep that in mind when we talk about our action plan and how we're going to follow up with our existing clients that have closed on properties. Like, what is the next step for them? Or even those people that maybe that aren't selling their properties that we know that are inside our circle of influence that we have in our database that have been in their homes for 35 years. Like, what's the next step for them? Well, let's build generational wealth through investment properties, right? So we may want to factor that in when we talk about those action steps that we're going to do to follow up, those emails that we're sending out, information that we provide them with. Maybe we need to start providing value on what it's like to own investment properties, what that looks like to get into investment properties, what programs are out there, how that can benefit them, right? So we want to think about that so that we can help our people build generational wealth and expand their investment portfolio. And the side of that is also that you get more transactions. So just kind of keep that in mind. We want to capture that. We also want to capture that referral business. We want to create raving fans. And that's one way to expand our circle of influence, right? So as we're interacting with people, as we close clients, we want to capture and make them our fans. So they're every time they hear real estate, they're saying Shauna, right? Somebody says real estate, they say Leticia, right? So that's what we want. We want them to become our fans and begin expanding our COI. The best bet for referral business, just so everybody knows, isn't go hand people a stack of your cards so they can hand them out. It's get contact information. So we need to be in constant communication with our people so that as they come across somebody that might be looking to buy, sell, or invest in real estate, they can hand off our information to them and also hand us their information. We want to be in charge of that contact. So we want to be able to reach out to those clients. So creating clients for life, staying in touch is easy if you have a plan and sticking to it, right? This is kind of what Jennifer was talking about before everybody hopped on. Like, okay, well, I've got people in a database. Now, what do I do with them? How do I follow up with them? How do I touch them? How frequently? How do I set them up so that half of that's automated, right? So we've got to have a plan and stick to it. So have an after sale action plan. In addition to that, since we're not just touching on like clients that have closed, have an action plan for that circle of influence that maybe hasn't done business with you, that's already kind of your cheerleaders, whether they're local or out of state. And we want to implement those plans as soon as we close that transaction or put those people into our database. You need to be consistent. It's all about consistency for it to produce results. Just so everybody knows, the stats show that if we're consistent in our communication with people that are in our database, the people that know our name, the people that we would consider contacts, not just captured, right? We're connected with them. 1 in 10 will transact or get you a transaction this year. Okay, 1 in 10. So if you wanna do 20 transactions and you've got 200 people in your database already that know you, you're already there. We just need to systematize the contact process so that we stay top of mind, so that we're asking for referrals, so that we're staying in communication with them and reminding them that we're in real estate. Okay. Here is that action plan. Okay. Simple but effective after sale action plan. This action plan doesn't just cover after sale. This would be for anybody in your database that knows your name. Okay. If they are connected with you, they see your phone number pop up, they see a text message from you, they're probably going to respond. This is your contact plan for them. I like to recommend what I call a 5-5-5, which is once a quarter, you're going to call them. Once a quarter, you're going to send them a text message. And once a quarter, you're going to interact with them on social media. Okay. So how that would look is, let's say that Jennifer is my client, or she's connected with me, she's in my database. April, we're almost in April. In April, I'm going to pick up the phone and call Jennifer. I'm going to have a conversation with her. Okay, that conversation is going to be what we call like a Ford sandwich, right? Family, occupation, recreation, dreams. Ford, F-O-R-D, family, occupation, recreation, dreams. We're going to talk about it. I may scroll through her social media before I contact her, so that I know what she's been up to. I know what things have been looking like for her if she's on social media. That way I can say, oh my gosh, Jennifer, I just saw that it looked like you had to take your dog to the emergency hospital last week. How is he doing? Right? I want to build rapport and relationship. And some of these people you may not have talked to in a while. You may have closed the sale with them and you haven't talked to them since. And that was 2 years ago, right? So we need to open up that conversation. So we're just going to have a conversation. How are things going? How's the house? Is everything treating you well? Work? Are you still working at Genentech? You know, whatever those are, we're going to have that conversation. Family, occupation, recreation, dreams. Now, if you haven't talked to these people in a while, because we haven't put this action plan into place immediately, moving forward, you won't have this problem. But if you haven't put it into place, your first conversation may be just that. Just checking in, see how things are going. I hope things continue to go well. Oftentimes you're like, hey, how's the job at Genentech going? And they're like, oh, it's going so good. We love it there. They take such good care of us. Are you still doing this, right? And that's your opportunity to be like, oh, well, now I'm doing real estate. Or yeah, I'm absolutely still doing real estate, right? So it's that opportunity to have that conversation back with them. It usually opens up to what are you doing? So it usually naturally progresses. But on the first phone call, if you haven't contacted them in a while, you may just want to leave it as, hey, I'm just checking in to see how things are going. I'm sorry that I've been negligent in calling you over the last 2 years, right? Like it just, hey, I'm sorry I haven't touched base sooner. How are things going, right? If we're implementing this action plan after every close, then, and we're starting to have regular conversations with people, then it's more of a Ford sandwich. Hey, how are things going? How's the house treating you, right? Family, occupation, recreation, dreams. Hey, I was just calling to touch base with you to see if you knew anybody else looking to buy, sell, or invest in real estate, right? Hey, rates are low. They just rolled out this new program where you can get 20% down payment assistance if you qualify. Do you know anybody that could use that to get into a house for a first time? Right? Great conversation to have with your past people. Do you know anybody that might benefit? Who can I reach out to that you know? right? And then you're going to close it up with family, occupation, recreation, dreams. You're going to close it up with, oh my gosh, well, I hope your job still goes well. I hope you have fun on vacation. Man, I sure hope it stops raining soon. Like, this is really getting a drag. I could really use some sunshine and, you know, my feet not to be soggy when I walk across the ground, whatever that is. Or that's why we call it a Ford sandwich. Wrap up the phone call, hop off, and then you can call those referrals. Okay. So you're going to call them. So if Jennifer was my client, we closed in March, I'm going to call her in April. In May, I don't know my months of the year, so it might take me a minute to get through. In May, I'm going to get on her social media and I'm going to comment on a post, right? I may even send her like a direct message depending, but I'm definitely going to like a post for like the day on another one, so that I'm interacting with them systematically on social media. Now you can set this up in your CRM. We talked about, like, if you're not using anything right now, I would wait just a week or two, because we're going to roll out a new one that I think will be more intuitive, a little bit easier to use. But if you're already plugged into a CRM, you're already using OneSuite, you can set these interactions up as tasks in there, so it reminds you to do these things, so that you don't have to remember who you're supposed to call. You can, oh, I talked to Jennifer today, so in 30 days, I'm going to comment on her social media. I'm going to add that at a task. It's going to send me a reminder in the morning to do that, right? In 30 days in the morning, I'm going to get a reminder that's going to tell me to interact with Jennifer on social media.
Okay. Amy, are you talking about just like your Google Calendar, or are you talking about in your CRM, there's actually something that you can do that?
In your CRM, you can actually set it up to do that.
Okay.
In addition, when I talked with Jennifer today, I'm going to make notes in my CRM of what we talked about, so that when it sends me a reminder next time to interact on social media, like, I remember what we talked about. I may want to send her a direct message on social media to follow up with something, right? So we can follow up. So you can save those notes in there and set those tasks. I would run my business, not necessarily on Google Calendar, but I would run it out of my CRM. Okay. Which is your contact relationship manager, in case anybody's like, what does that really stand for? What is a CRM? It's your contact relationship manager. It's your database. Okay. So April phone call, May, we're going to interact on social media. And then June, I'm going to send her a text message, right? If she's local, I may be like, hey, Jennifer, I was just in your area and I was thinking about you. I hope you're doing well. Right? It doesn't have to be anything extravagant. It can just be a check-in. Hope you're doing well. Just to remind them that, hey, I'm here. I do real estate. I'm thinking about you, right? Who doesn't like to get a text message that's just like, hey, I was just in your area. I was thinking about you. I hope you're having a great day. Right? Don't need anything. Don't do anything, right? Just those. So that's how the calls, the text message, and social media works. We've covered 3 months. Now we're going to repeat, right? So we got April, May, and June. Now we got July, August, and September. So Jennifer's going to get a call in July. She's going to get social media in August, and she's going to get a text message in September. And we just keep rinsing and repeating every 3 months. Okay. Calls, text message, social media. You'll have 4 phone calls in the year. You'll have 4 text messages, and you'll have 4 social media interactions. You'll probably end up with more, because then they'll start interacting with you more. You want to make sure you invite those people to at least one event. And you're like, Amy, an event, that sounds expensive. No, it's not. Number one, we do lots of fun things in the office. Like, they open the office up for all sorts of random things, like block your clients off by, you know, last name, by number, by date they closed, and then invite them like, hey, we do this thing at our office. We'd love for you to join us for the concert in the park, or whatever it is, concert in town square, right? This week, and invite 5 or 6 people to it, right? There's national night out. You can claim a neighborhood, like a park, and host a national night out in the park and invite all of your clients to join you at national night out. Super fun. You can register the park, and that way the sheriffs show up and the police cars and the fire trucks and the dump trucks and all sorts of things show up. We did it 1 year. We made it like a potluck. Everybody brought food to share. It was super fun. So, right. So you can make events really cheap and free, or you could like rent out the movie theater and invite everybody to watch a movie. Right. So you could do, depends on what you want to do, how you want to roll it. You may be like, Amy, I just really love happy hour. Great. Break your clients in the group and invite them to happy hour with you. Right. Once a week, I'm going to invite 3 people to happy hour. By the end of the year, I've got everybody invited to happy hour. You're getting more interactions because you're inviting them to the happy hour. If they join you at the happy hour, you're connecting with them on a personal level. And then after the happy hour, you can either send them a message and be like, hey, thanks so much for joining me. That was so much fun. Can't wait to do it again. Or, hey, so sorry we missed you and you weren't able to make it. We had fun, but you can make it to the next one. right? So it's super easy. You've got some extra connections there, and it's all about building relationship. So invite to at least one event, two is better. You want to do 4 pop buys or mailed items. Okay. And you're like, Amy, what's a pop buy? Right. So by mailed item, I don't mean like a card. I mean like send them a magnetic calendar in the mail, something tangible that they can hold on to and keep. Okay. Something fun. Maybe it's been raining a lot. So you're going to send them a little umbrella in the mail and say, just thinking about you, hope you're doing okay with all this rain, right? One of those little like drink umbrellas, just something fun, right? Or you could do it as a pop by, which is something that we would leave on their porch, right? So we could do like something fun. We did one year where we did little pumpkins around November. And we just said, we're super thankful. We ended up passing them out in November. They were like baking pumpkins for pie. And we just said a little tag on them that said something like, super thankful that you're our client. Please let us know if, you know, we can help any of your friends and family or something like that. It was way more clever. If you need something clever, there's a website you can go to. If you search Realtor Pop Buys, there's actually a website that has a whole bunch of ideas. And you also will see them on like Pinterest. We'll give you a bunch of ideas. Yes, Leticia.
I usually do every year for my, you know, for my clients that I mostly know, they know me better. I do poinsettias every year for Christmas. I just leave them a plant, and then they text me back or call me back saying thank you, and they love it. So I've been doing that every year. For all my clients, so they like it.
People love it, right? They love to walk out on their doorstep. You don't even have to knock on their door. You can just leave it on their doorstep and run away. It's totally like
suck up the time. They're waiting for me for a present for me. So
yeah, so super cool.
If I tell them that I'm going.
Your connection's really bad. It's really choppy. It's hard to understand you.
Hey, Leticia? Leticia, can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes,
I think you have the same problem I do. You might need to go to a different part of your house and get closer to your internet connection, because I can't even use my office upstairs because I can't go. It doesn't work on video either. So you might need to change where you are, because we can't hear you. It's breaking up a lot.
Yeah, it keeps getting really choppy.
Yeah, so maybe try to change your location.
Oh, okay. Okay, I'll move.
I'm
going to go somewhere else.
Okay. And your computer may not be able to handle the video and voice at the same time. Cause when you take your video off, like you just did, I can hear you just fine. So it might be that connection that the speed of your computer can't handle it.
Can you hear me better?
Uh-huh. Absolutely.
Oh, so maybe that's what it was. I think it
came
together.
Yeah, the second you took your video away, I could hear you just
fine.
Oh,
sorry. Okay, so I guess you won't see me. Sorry about that.
No problem.
But did you hear what I said about the pop buys that I do?
Yes.
Okay. All right.
Yes.
I just wanted to share that.
You do the little plant, and then your people get really excited about them. And then they end up calling you or texting you to follow up.
Yes.
Yes. Right? And
thank
that's
you.
The goal. We want them to interact with us. So, right. So do pop buys. You can do it in the mail. You can do it, drop it off on their doorstep. You may do like 2 in the mail and 2 on their doorstep. I would recommend one of those be a market analysis, right? Most of these people are clients. We've sold them a house or they own a house. Run a market analysis on their property once a year and either shoot that to them in the mail or drop it off on their doorstep and just say, hey, just wanted to keep you up to date of what's going on in your neighborhood and with your property. And here's kind of the analysis of where it would be at in today's market. Super simple. You can run it through Cloud CMA.
Okay. I was going to ask you on that note, because you know, Cloud CMA is like a 20 page. Are you talking about like that full blown market analysis? Or are you just talking about like the first couple of pages that says what the value of their house is or whatever?
Yeah. So, well, you know, there's actually a couple different ways, but if you do a cloud CMA, you can take a lot of those pages out of there. So my cloud CMA is probably only like maybe 10 pages max. And that's because it's got pictures of the comps. So you can customize your CMA. So I've got it like a title page and then like, the Zillow value and the comps and, like what is a CMA, I think is, I mean, you can really narrow it down small, or there's also a, we have the access through, I think it's called RPM through Barry's. And that one will also pull like an analysis. It's a really quick way to do it. Actually, you can just plug in those addresses and it spits out a value on it. That might be a good way to do it. That's really quick. That doesn't need a whole bunch of pages.
You said that's in Barry's?
That's in Barry's under the tools bar where it's got, I think it's called RPM.
RPR. Are you talking about RPR?
RPR, yeah. I was like, it's RP something.
Okay. Yeah. Cause that, well, that one I used to use before I went to cloud, and that one is actually even longer than cloud. So I think I have to just figure out how to set the settings so I don't have all those pages.
All those pages. Let me know if you need help with that, but it's as you're going through the CMA, you can customize it. Once you customize it, you can pull out some of those pages.
Nice. Okay, cool. Thanks.
Perfect. Right. So these are all these personal connections and interactions. So 4 phone calls, 4 text messages, 4 social media interactions, an invite to an event, and then 4 pop buys or mailed items or a combination are those personal connection items. In addition to those, we are also going to do 12 emailed or mailed newsletters, right? And that might be something simple. We can, again, we can set this up through our CRM to automatically send an emails out to everybody, or we can schedule it so that it sends it really easily. So you don't have to like plug in everybody's email addresses. So we can go through that. Well, we will, once we roll out the new CRM, I'll be helping teach you guys how to utilize that one appropriately, or we can show you how to do it through OneSuite. And then you also want to set them up for an electronic or an email market update that they can get on a monthly basis. The easy way to do that is to use RealScout. So RealScout has a really nice market update that you can set to go out to them on a monthly basis. Okay, the reason I like to use RealScout for one and a CRM for the other is because if they unsubscribe from one, they're still getting the other one. Right? So they can run, but they can't hide. Oh, so anyways, that's why I like to use 2 systems. And also the RealScout market updates. It's a really clean and nice looking market update. In addition to that, I would send them like a birthday card and a holiday card. And it can be a random holiday card. It might be like Happy St. Patty's Day instead of like Christmas, because everybody sends out Christmas cards and you want to stand out. So I would recommend doing that. So you're going to get another 26 touches in through either email or mail. Through these items that are a little bit more generic. Okay, if you have a big database, you may want to look at something like send out cards or AM cards, where you can log in and they send those cards out for you instead of you having to like stamp them and mail them and buy the cards. Sometimes it's less expensive to go through one of those services than it is to go buy cards and mail them out on your own, especially since the price of stamps just keeps going up. Okay. So any questions about those action those steps in the action plan to do for all of the people in your database that you either have closings with or that you have a personal connection with? Good. All right. In addition, our non-clients. So these aren't non-connected. These are people we know, people that love us, people that trust us. They just haven't done a transaction with us. We want cheerleaders. So just because they haven't used you doesn't mean they can't refer you. And we can also get out of the area referrals. So never cross anybody off your list or take anybody out of your database because they moved out of the area or because they never lived in the area. We can help connect them with clients wherever they live, anywhere in the United States, and collect that referral fee. So we can help find them a stellar agent and collect that referral fee. So we want to still involve our non-clients in this process, which is why that action plan I would implement on anybody in your database that knows you, loves you, trusts you, that knows your name, that would answer your phone call. Those we're going to turn into cheerleaders. Okay. We can also level up our creating clients for life, right? Let's level up this process. So your friends, family members, your spheres, our circle of influence, that's what COI stands for, circle of influence, and clients are lucky to have an agent as skilled as you, right? You're growing, you're learning, you know how to transact business well. They are lucky to know an agent as skilled as you. They are going to want to refer their friends, family, and coworkers to you. They're going to be unaccustomed to the level of care and consistency for which you are connecting with them. And they are going to brag with you. Okay, so we're going to level up. So some ways to level up are an evaluation. Create an evaluation form and you can send it to the title company and ask them to send it to your client with the final closing package for them to complete and get back to you. Okay, where they're going to fill out your level of service. How did you do? What could you have done better, right? They could rate it. So there's lots of different things you can do with this evaluation form, but you can send it out at closing with that notary to get completed by your client at time of closing. It gives you a thermometer of whether we're going to ask for reviews or we're going to ask how to fix it if they had a bad experience. Okay, makes sense? We're getting feedback. If you've had closings, well, we'll get into that here in a minute. We'll go into that in a minute here. Here we go. Take two. See, I already had a slide for that. It's not too late. If you had closings and you didn't ask for feedback, it's not too late. You can go back and ask, right? You could go back to a previous client and say, hey, I'm just evaluating my business and I never asked you how I did. Can you provide me with some feedback so that I can level up my service, right? What could I have done better? What did I do well, right? Ask for feedback from past clients so that you can move forward. You can take that and implement it into your business. Feedback is important. Any questions about evaluation?
No.
Are you suggesting you're asking for the evaluation and the feedback in addition to a review, or are you just asking for the review?
I'm going to ask for that evaluation before I ask for a review. Okay. That way I know what that review is going to say ahead of time.
Okay.
Right. If they had a bad experience, I don't want to ask for reviews until I fix that.
Right.
Until I make it better.
And you said the title company has this evaluation form that can be sent out at close of escrow?
No. So you would want to create your own evaluation form and then you can send it to title right before the close of escrow and be like, hey, do you mind sending this with the closing package for the client to complete at time that they're doing their final signing?
Gotcha. Okay. I missed that part. And then ask title company to send new client. Okay. Yep. Got it.
Do you have a sample one that you could send us?
I do not have a sample one that I know of. I've lost that one, but I will see if I can locate one and create a folder for it. Eval.
Thank you, ma'am.
I will make one. All right. In addition, we can ask for reviews, as Jennifer brought up, right? Once we get that evaluation form, we kind of know what direction it's going to go. We never want to ask for reviews from somebody that's going to give us a negative review. So we can ask for reviews. Places that people can review are Yelp, Google, social media, realtor.com, Zillow, right? All those places. There, we do have a Rate My Agent site that's connected with our One Zone area. However, to get it to link everything together, you have to pay for a service fee, and I'm not a big fan of that. I like free. So you can organically ask for reviews on all of these, and there's like five of them. There's probably more. So if you broke down where you want reviews from, you might want to make it fun and do rewards for leaving reviews or do a drawing like, hey, anybody who leaves me a review on Yelp this month gets entered into a drawing for a gift card for a restaurant, right? Or, and then maybe the next month it's, hey, Google, right? So you might want to alternate it by month and continue asking for reviews and getting feedback. And again, you can make it fun with rewards or drawings, a gift card, if they like a $5 gift card to Starbucks, maybe if they leave you a review right after closing. And maybe it's they get $1 per review they leave on their gift card or $2 per review that they leave on their gift card. So if they leave it on all five locations, they get a $10 gift card. It will help your business grow. I promise you have reviews. People are checking out your reviews. So you can make it something fun like that. Or you could do it like, hey, you get entered into a drawing for every review you leave on every site. You get entered into a monthly drawing. Okay. Any questions about reviews?
Yeah, actually, I have a question. Yeah. So I usually ask for like Zillow, which is the most known site. Because I don't want to ask them, you know, I don't want to ask them, you know, over and over. Like you said, I didn't know that, you know, that I could ask them for several times. But I usually have them on Zillow. Uh-huh. So is there a way to link them with other sites? Or
there is not. Or that's nobody the, that's nice it. Together.
Okay.
Okay. That is something that Rate My Agent does. So Rate My Agent will take the review and then they'll push it out to different sites depending on your level of membership. But again, you got to pay for that. I would rather just have them leave. And then the other thing is with Rate My Agent too, is that if you stop paying them, I believe they take all the reviews off those sites. So then you lose reviews. When I first got started in real estate, I did a service like that, that solicited the reviews and then pushed them out everywhere. And then I learned really quickly that when I stopped paying for their service, they took all the reviews back. And those were my reviews.
Same thing happened with when I was at the other company. I had a bunch of reviews on their platform that they had.
Yeah.
And so when I moved, they kept everything. There was nothing I could do to transfer them. So yeah. it kind of, I was not happy about that.
Yeah. So that's why oftentimes I say do it organically and go to each place. And when I ask for those reviews, I'll usually like go to Zillow, find my profile as a consumer and where it says like rate the agent or whatever, and actually send them links. So when they click on the link, it takes them right to that review spot that they don't have to make 50 clicks, that it's one click to get them to the location where they leave that review. And you can ask for, you know, you could do them, like I said, all at once, like after the close of escrow, and be like, hey, you know, you get a gift card for each review that you leave, or, you know, money on a gift card for each review, and, or like enter into a drawing for the end of the month, or you could send them out like every 2 months, a request, or every month, a request for a different location. Like, hey, if you haven't left a review yet on realtor.com, don't miss out on this month's drawing. Anybody who leaves me a review, you know, gets entered into the drawing for a gift certificate for a local restaurant, right? Like something fun. Some fun ways to get those and solicit and provide them incentive to be able to do that. In addition, create your vendor list, right? We want to be the go-to for everything local that they may want or need, not just house related. So you want to connect up with businesses that are house related, right? Like your contractors, your roofers, your plumbers, your electricians, your landscapers, your handyman, right? Anything that's house related, create a list of vendors for those items. In addition, create a list of personal services. Like who do you recommend that does nails or that is the barber or the salon or, right? Who are you connecting with? And then also, you know, local restaurants and stuff or things to do, activities, events for, you know, activities for kids under 5, activities for kids, you know, 5 to 10, you know, activities for teens. Like create a vendor list of all these different things and places and fun things to do. Something that's fun too is like around Halloween, like create a list of all of the pumpkin places, right? All the pumpkin patches, and send that out to all your clients. But create this list. And this is a good opportunity to work those business to business referrals to build relationships with those business owners, right? Gym owners, restaurants, personal services, and say, hey, I've got a database of 300 people that I'm going to be marketing your services to, or that I would like to market your services to with your permission. I can't think of what the word is, but reply, that's not the right word. I can't come up with it, but because I'm doing that, would you be willing to refer people to me for my real estate services? And most business owners are like, yeah, you're giving me free promotion. Absolutely. Or maybe even can I leave my cards at your counter or with the other business cards that office or that place has available to their clients, right? So doctors, dentists, right? Think anybody that you use, you can create a vendor list for. A really good way to use that vendor list is inside of, let me see if I can find it. We have at our fingertips, we have Move Easy, which is a fabulous system. Number one, you can plug all your clients in here for moving, and it's a moving concierge service. It'll help direct them in the right path and get their utilities going in the right direction, right? To get all their utilities set up. So they have the Move Easy portion of it. And then they also have a vendor portion of it where you can add all of your vendors here and then you can share that. So anybody who has access to the system, they have access to your vendors to be able to search them. You can invite all your clients to the system. You can also download your vendor list and send it to people. So this is a great opportunity to create reciprocal relationships with business to business and be able to be just the plethora of information for clients and people so that they know that, hey, when I need something, I can call Maciel and she'll know the best salon to use, or she's going to know where the pumpkin patches are. She's got a list for that, right? So super fun way to connect with your clients and just level up that post-closing service. Okay, any questions about creating that vendor list?
Amy, I used Movie years ago with one of my clients, and I set him up with it and everything, but then he contacted me a little while later and he said, you know, he said that MoveEasy thing that you set me up with, he said they want me to give them money, like they want me to pay for it. And I was like, I wasn't aware of that. I thought it was a free service. And he said, no, they wanted me to pay for it, so I don't want it. And I was like, oh, okay, you know. And I had no idea. Do you know anything about that?
Yeah, for the basic MoveEasy service, I just talked to them at Summit. I know that that's a free service, that concierge to help them set up utilities. And it may get them the phone numbers and everything to do it. Now, if they actually want them to like pull the trigger and make all the phone calls and do all the arrangements, that might be a fee, but I'm not sure from that side. I actually signed up for it myself when we moved to see how it worked. Unfortunately, they didn't have any services. They didn't have the services for where I live. Nobody does. But
yeah, that's what you get for moving out there.
That's what I get for moving out there. But they never asked me for any fee associated with that. But you could always just set yourself up, like do a fictitious move and kind of roll through the service and just be like, oh, I just wanted to, you know, experience what my clients are experiencing. So I just wanted to test and see what this was all about and throw yourself in there.
Okay.
It's always a good idea. But yeah. But they do have that way that you can put your vendors in there. All right. And we want to ask for referrals, right? The number one reason people don't get referrals is because they never asked for them. So, right. So we've talked about reviews. We've talked about the vendor list, right? Stepping up our level of service. And then we also have to ask. If you don't ask, you don't get it, right? Mahatma Gandhi. Ask for referrals throughout the transaction, right? Who else do they know that might be interested in buying, selling, or investing in real estate? Who else do they know that you should help, right? Oh my gosh, thank you so much for working out that repair credit. We so appreciate that. Great. Who else do you know that could use my services, right? Great way to do that. There is a promise script that you can use for this to set yourself up from the very beginning of the transaction. So at about your second significant interaction with your clients, where maybe at the time that you're signing a listing agreement or sitting down at the listing appointment, right? Even before that listing agreement gets signed, or maybe at the time that you're sitting down doing the buyer presentation or going through that buyer the buyer representation and broker compensation form, this would be a good time to work in the promise. And the promise rules something like this, right? Hey, my goal is to provide you with a 5-star experience. I'm going to deliver such amazing service that you're going to want to refer me. And if you don't refer me, I am going to assume it's because I have done something wrong and I will want to talk to you about what I could have done better for you. Could you do that? People were like, yeah, I want 5-star experience. And yeah, if I have a good experience, why would I not refer? Like, yeah, absolutely. And then you're going to say, perfect. Thank you. I'm going to count on you for that referral. All right. And they're going to be like, cool. Yes. And then good idea is to shake hands at that point when they're like, yeah, we can do that. And then you'd want to clarify with, and just so we're clear, if we get to closing and you haven't been in touch with me, giving me the name of someone I can help, I'm going to assume that I haven't delivered on my promise and that I could have done something better. So I'm going to want to talk to you to find out what I could have done to earn that referral. Would it be okay with you to do that, right? You're asking them permission to approach them in the case that they don't get you a referral, right? You're setting yourself up at the beginning of the transaction for a success and you're setting yourself up for referrals. Who wants referrals? Anybody?
I do.
Me.
Right? Everybody does. Me, right? We all want referrals. So this promise script is a great way to set yourself up for that. And it's a great way to make it less intimidating to ask for those referrals. Because sometimes we find like at the end of the transaction, it's kind of awkward. Like, oh, well, hopefully you got good service. Like, who else do you know, right? So this is setting yourself up for that so that throughout the transaction, you can check in. Jay, just checking in to see how my level of service is. Is there anything that you would like me to change or anything that you feel like I'm dropping the ball on, right? And who else do you know that I can help buy, sell, or invest in real estate, right? Super easy. So work in that promise script. And then you can also roll out, right? We're talking about how to level up your service. You could roll out, if you wanted to, a referral rewards type program, right? You're going to reward the act of referring. So if somebody refers somebody to you, you might reward that with a gift card. It might be like a $5 like coffee house gift card for the first referral. And then if they close, maybe you give them a gift card to the dinner place of choice, right? Like that referral is worth $10,000 to $12,000 for you. So to reward somebody back with a $100 gift card to a restaurant for that referral, totally, totally fun and a good way to reward them. In addition, you might say, hey, if you refer anybody to me, because I want to make sure that I service your friends and family well, I'm going to give them $1,000 credit on their closing costs, right? So you may decide to do something like that. Or if you refer somebody to me on your next purchase or sale, you will also get a credit of on the closing costs of $1,000, right? So you might work something out like that. And it might be like $1,000 toward per referral for somebody that refers business to you. And you want to make sure you keep track of that, but they could like potentially earn a free commission if they refer 12 clients to you that all transact with you, right? So you could do some sort of fun referral rewards program. And that would also give you the opportunity to promote that program. Like, hey, we offer a referral rewards program. If you use us for your transaction, then refer us to your friends and family. Like everybody wins. Any question about referrals?
No.
No. All right. We have reached the end of our Creating Customers for Life. I want to remind you to make sure you follow through with your one habit in order to see results in your business. Have three conversations today about real estate. Make sure you add three people to your database and send out three handwritten notes in the mail, because people love getting handwritten notes in the mail. If you want to level this up, bump it all up to 10, do a 10, 10, 10, and you'll have results faster. Did anybody have any questions about today's material or any ahas or thoughts about what we covered?
No, sorry, I was late.
Totally appropriate. Okay to be late.
No, it was good advice, Amy, like always. Thank you.
Good. I'm glad you enjoyed it.
I'm just happy that I actually understood how to do all of this stuff.
Good.
Because usually I'll sit through one of these things going, okay, I still don't know how to do it. So this one was simple. This one I can do.
Good. Good.
No tech involved. Well, yeah, the database is tech, so that's going to be an issue. But everything else, there was no tech involved. So good
for
me. You
could do this with zero tech, right? You could just set yourself on your calendar. You could have a analog written calendar in front of you. I talked with Jennifer today. You can make a note on that calendar to send her a text message in 30 days. Like, you could do it completely non-techie and not have anybody in a database. I don't recommend that though.
Very true. Yes. Yes. Very true. I do have one question though.
Yeah.
Completely off topic.
Yeah.
How do I get my picture on my name? Everybody that does this, that doesn't want their video camera going, they have their professional picture there, but I have no idea how to put my picture up there.
All right. So that
how do you guys do it?
Jennifer, I'll show you Friday at the Zoom meeting.
Oh, awesome. Cool.
There we go.
I'm with you, Jen. I'm low tech. I like that it's low tech. And I put my picture in there. I don't know how. Honestly, I know it's there, but I don't even know how I did it. So just luck.
I tried and tried. I spent so much time and finally I got so mad. I was like, screw it. I don't care anymore. And I just walked away.
If it makes you feel better, Jennifer, if I hit stop video on this profile. Oh, I don't know where it went. I think this one has a picture, but sometimes I log in, there is no picture. So, you know, it's all. Gotcha. It's all funky.
Yeah.
I'm only semi-techie.
You know what? I did this with, I can show my picture when I'm on my phone, but I don't know how to do it when I'm on my computer. That I don't know how to do it. So I know it's from my phone and I just look for a picture on my phone. And but on my computer, I don't know how to do it, honestly.
You need to be there on Friday so Anastasia can show you too.
I'll be there.
Thank you for the posting of my picture.
Thank you for the posting of your picture.
Oh, I see it on the Zoom right now
Oh,
where
you
it
must
was.
have
Oh, shoot. Well, I don't know how I did
that. See, so I'm not the
it. I don't know what happened, honestly.
one. That's awesome. Okay. You're like, I just show up. I don't know.
Well, I show up sometimes. I have another job and I sneak in the Zoom.
In the chat box is a link to log your attendance for us. So the office has record of who showed up to the training.
And
And
you have to say what other trainings you want, or it won't let you submit it.
oh, make
FYI.
suggestions on trainings. Fabulous. You could say nothing if you didn't have an idea, but make ideas, make suggestions. Fabulous. If everybody's good for today, nobody else has questions, then we will wrap up tomorrow at 4 o'clock. We have My NHD. We have Britt from My NHD joining us to go over the natural hazard zone disclosure report, why it's important, what you'd find in there, how to utilize it. And I'm sure he'll cover some other little tidbits of information that you've probably never heard before, because every time you watch a training like that, you that one's on Zoom. And then just a reminder, next Thursday, we have the title company coming to the office. It'll also be on Zoom to share all about the preliminary title report, red flags, all sorts of useful information when it comes to title and escrow.
Is that the guy that we ran into at Summit?
Britt, I don't know that Britt was at Summit. He may have been at Summit. It may have been, I think it was like Steve and Britt, maybe.
Okay.
I know Steve was one of them. I don't know who, I don't remember the other guy's name.
Okay.
So yeah, but same company, My NHD, because we have a partnership with them. So that's tomorrow at 4.
Thank you, ma'am.
Cool. Thank you. Everybody have a fabulous day. If you guys need anything, never hesitate to reach out to me. I'm always here to help. Thank you,
Thank
Amy.
you.
You're
Thank
welcome.
you.
Bye, everybody.
Bye.